Hello and welcome to a new ranked season. Ta-da! First of all, I don't make a ship recommendations video for this one because it's still tier 10 and I think most of the ships that I did in my video for the ranked season 14 are still unchanged, more or less. I think, except for the ones that I totally excluded, I think you can play almost everything. Tier 10 is kind of okay-ish in that regard. Yeah, there are some ships that are a bit stronger and others that aren't. So, but I mean, Hindenburg, definitely more viable. But if you want to have an influence on the game, you either play DD carriers, because they are now allowed in the game, and or ships like with radar and so on. So that's basically how it always works. And obviously battleships, because they have the staying power. Alright, yeah. Who do I feature? Well, I think I thought I'd start this with Sturf, because, as you all know, he likes to play aggressive and he has kind of a crush for the Russian heavy cruisers. So, if you remember back in the days, Kronstadt, well, this time it's Stalingrad. And I think it was also last season when I featured him, he also played a lot of Stalingrad. And yeah, he really likes that ship and is a really capable player of doing what is necessary to take, yeah, actions to win the game, right? Alright, so he's doing things that usually most players won't do, and that might be a bit awkward for the other players in the team. Basically, he's playing it wide on the flank. Why is he doing that? Well, he has the tools for it. He has radar, he has nasty guns and the range, he has defensive AA, yes, there are carriers in the game, so it won't help that much, and especially with the current plane HP regen bug. It's like a pain in the ass. On the other hand, Wargaming is working on that, just that you are aware of it. Alright, so he's going wide on the flank. What's the goal with that? Well, first of all, having nasty shots into the enemy. Second of all, occupy other ships, and he's doing that mostly alone. The tankiness of the Stalingrad, the good armor, allows it to play this kind of role. Yeah, concealment is garbage and so on, and if you're like a good player, then you usually don't have too many issues getting the most out of it. Obviously shooting mainly AP because of the good AP penetration angles, which can punish cruisers or battleships alike. And yeah, he's doing his best to take apart the enemy yeah, ships. Minotaur, he can overmatch with the 305s, so he's taking the shots. And yeah, you see here kind of a pattern. Okay, the Ohio is coming now as well to support him. But you will also check a bit the chat. If people see you doing that and not being stationary next to like areas where the cap will appear at some point, I will go over this in a second, then they get mad at you and like want to report you and so on, because they don't understand what you are doing. Alright, so about the mode. This is Arms Race. So basically these little circles that you see give you some buffs. Basically HP regeneration, mobility, like rudder shift time decrease, and what do we have else? Was it speed? I'm not sure. I can't say all of them because I didn't play yet, but they give you just buffs. So if you obtain it, everybody in your team will get the buff. So this is always pretty helpful. Furthermore, there is no cap circle yet. So the cap circle is basically like in a big circle in the middle, where a bit like an epicenter where you get where the team or which if you want to gather points, I mean you get gain points by obtaining or just getting these buffs, but yeah, that's by the way the first blood award, and Kuznetsov, the captain that he's running, is activated. That means he has this nice heal at the end, if necessary. But back to that, the circle is basically like a huge cap, so to say. And yeah, you wanna get it capped at some point if you wanna win the game. Or you kill as many ships as possible and you can ignore it more or less. So it's always great to know what you're doing, and in this case Sturf knows what he's doing. So seems as if some people don't take notice, like the Smolensk, because he's like well hidden behind that island. Why is he behind that island? Well, he knows the Venezia is coming. I didn't know if he knows that the Daring was there, but I assume so. Sturf is experienced enough. So how does he get out of this pickle? I mean, right now he's radaring for information. He wants to know where he's going, what is happening. And he's not panicking, he's not running, he's just waiting. So it looks as if the Venezia is coming from behind. That's Smolensk. Well, he stopped in time, let's put it like this. Oh yeah, by the way, that's also a thing where you can play the Stalingrad because of, like, Smolensk. You push in, you radar, and you can overmatch them. So that's also a big thing against Smolensk, and I think that's pretty much the hard counter to the Smolensk. It was last season and it is still in this season. So let's see. The Daring didn't appear, but he was turning around, so Sturf is probably expecting him to come around. All stations reporting the position of a strategic. And he asks for some support, but as you see, nobody here. And the Daring is right in front of him, smoking up. So some people would panic, but what is Sturf doing? Switching to HE? Well, the radar is off. Okay. But what can he expect? Well, Torps into his position, right? And I have to criticize this play of the Daring, because what is this goal here? I mean, he wants Sturf that Torps are coming his way. Second of all, he completely negated what Venezia was doing. The best play for the Daring would have been to rush him. So now he's spotted, but that's by the Smolensk. And there the torpedoes pass him. That's at least one set. And now he's playing Ring Around Rosie with the Venezia, who should be like now here. And yeah, that was the classic outplay, I would say. Smolensk. Don't forget that these two also opened up the lower half of the map for Sturf now. So this is obviously what you don't wanna get. If you're doing such a move, you should maybe coordinate it. Yeah, that Smolensk has to run for his life now. But that doesn't work anymore. And he's dead. Venezia stayed actually at this position. Yeah. These like super hard hitting not Italian torpedoes. Sturf doesn't care. He's loading the AP and is approaching slowly. Just checking if he can get some torpedoes, some volleys off into the Venezia. Let's see. I think the Venezia also topped on the side that he is just currently in. So that is very questionable what the Venezia is doing. I think here he aimed a bit too far behind. I don't know. Or too much in the center, next to the two citadels, and that's the Venezia dealt with, more or less. Unless he gets another torpedo salvo off. Which he... yeah, he probably will. But doesn't help him anymore. Sturf is trying to turn in, but he will definitely E2, and Kuznetsov is activated. So yeah, talking about OP, that captain is definitely really, really recommended if you're playing a Russian ship in this. Is it Kremlin? Maybe even Smolensk is on Smolensk it's helpful, or any Russian DD. If you get the first blood achievement, then you activate it. So that's pretty good. Press H to open the list of buffs. I don't know what this is again in the replay, or it's probably again a replay buff bug or whatever. On the other hand, while Sturf is doing his utmost to win the game, his team is not cooperating that much. But, well, we all know it, right? It's ranked. What the fuck are you doing all the time, Kleber? I don't know. He's just farming damage, what the Kleber is supposed to do. That would be my assumption, at least. And Sturf is now going aggressively in. The enemy Daring smoked up right in front of him. And obviously he's going to radar. Let's see if the Smolensk has time to shoot him as well. 6k. Some good Smolensk servos should be fine. When I watched it yesterday the first time, I thought the Smolensk was a bit slow, but if you consider the a radar delay, then probably not. He's trying his best. Requesting fire on the designated target. Not the best aiming, that's what you can maybe say. Some blind shots from Sturf, maybe hits him. Nope. Alright, what to do next? Yeah, I guess he will... The team has the Kleber there in the north, the Yamato in the north, so if you want to establish a crossfire, then you have to go south. Smolensk is fairly safe behind that island, that's a good position. Nobody can spot him, and if Sturf is occupying the southern part of the map, then it's absolutely fine, I think. But it's how you play Stalingrad in a nutshell. Not stationary or whatever. This ship is not made. You can play it, like, yes, you can play it stationary, but you will get burned down and so on, and shed on by Thunderers and Conquerors and Smolensk and so on. So you could argue angled away, but you could also play it like Sturf. Really aggressive. Always on the objective. Kleber goes down. Now it looks a bit dire if you look at the points. By the way, meanwhile, I don't know after how many minutes the circle, the cap circle in the middle appears, but it's after a while. Now he's waiting for Daring Torps because he was spotted while advancing this route, and I guess he anticipates Daring Torpedoes. And there is the Daring. Requesting fire on the designated target. Most likely has topped him. Concentrate fire all stations. Concentrate fire on the target. Yeah, there they come. He will take two or one. Only one. Okay, but the attention. Reporting the target. So that's also a thing you have to always take in consideration. And will the Daring survive another time? Yes. very sustainable ship, it looks like. Next HP buff gathered. So that's obviously helpful. I mean, these buffs also stack, right? So if you get one, you get two, and so on and so on. So the percentage that you heal per second is also increased. So spotted, could be left side, right side, I don't know. Oh, that was not the best choice of the Minotaur there. But yeah, he got away. Lucky for him. And Sturf rams himself here into the island just to be safe from torpedoes, I assume. Yeah, I guess so. And maybe he can make a play here. And he gets the Daring now. The side expects torpedoes. Okay, that was one set of torpedoes. He might have another one. That's the Minotaur torpedoes. And yeah, from there on, it's pretty simple. Oh yeah, reload speed of the consumables is also a buff. Yay. And yeah, that's basically the game. So what, it's up to you to decide what, if you had an influence on the game. I would say quite a lot. If you look at the counter, 4 kills, maybe make it 5, looks like it. Yeah, that's kill number 5, the Kraken. Expecting torpedoes, that's probably why he's turning into the Minotaur. I assume he didn't have the time. He's turning around, swinging his turrets around. But the Minotaur had the time, so yeah. Ah, okay, he launched them at the Yamato. I might have fallen for that, to be honest. So that was a good work here of Sturf. Always keep in mind that there are always battleships, or sometimes battleships behind you, where torps are aimed at. And there the Thunderer goes down, and that's the victory. So, what can we learn? Well, play Stalin aggressive, and you have a lot of fun, and a lot of influence on the game. He showed me also some other replays, where he was against carriers. And yeah, carriers are shitting on you, because, especially Hakurius with the AP bombs. But he always went into positions where he has nasty broadside shots. Yeah, eventually he will go down to the CV, but at that point he often enough had so much impact that his team was able to win. So, yeah, this aggressive playstyle works probably most of the time. If I remember correctly, last season he had like an astonishing win rate of like almost 80 to 90%, so that tells you something. Alright, yeah, let's look quickly at the base XP. Let's look also. Oh, that's already. Oh, that's rank 9, so that's not really. Yeah, top. Or, nah, well, it's at the start of the season, so you might find a lot of top players there in this early stages of the rank season. But yeah, 3.7. K base XP in a ranked game. Oof. But I think you have to add in the buffs that gives you probably also points. So if you collect these buffs, then yeah, I guess you gain some points as well. But yeah, you see how much impact he had. I mean, he killed like Minotaur, Smolensk, Stalingrad, quite a lot of ships, simply. To put it mildly. And yeah, maybe you can use this not as a blueprint, but as a like a guidance. If you want to play Stalingrad and play it aggressive, that's how you do it. I mean, you have to have a lot of awareness. You have to have some quite a lot of experience. You have to make your shots count. That's really important, because in the situations with the Venezia and so on, that's basically what you should do. And yeah, but then you can roll like Stove does. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope that was a good intro into this ranked season. Yeah, of course, other clan battle stuff will also follow. And yeah, I mean, it's kind of a bit stressful. Then I have also a lot of good random games and so on and so on. But yeah, I wanted to show you this because it's a really good game and I like to feature that one. Apart from that, wish you a nice day. See you next time. Bye-bye.